Hi, it's Forrest Brazeal, and this is Dear Gurus, where we answer your pressing questions about your cloud career. And our question today comes from a number of our learners here at ACG, and that is, how many certifications do I need to get my first job in the cloud? Now, the first thing I want to get out on the table right off the bat is, to some extent, that's kind of the wrong question to ask. There is not a hiring manager on the face of the planet who's going to look at your resume and go, oh, this person has 3 cloud certifications. They are a must hire. You know, that's not going to happen because for the most part, hiring managers understand that you need more than just certifications, just a piece of paper, if you will, to prove that you can actually do the work of a cloud professional. You've got to show some experience of some sort. And frankly, if a hiring manager didn't understand that, you probably wouldn't want to work for them anyway. And yet we know that there is value to cloud certifications. I've got a number of those certs myself. They've been quite helpful to me in my career as an engineer. So today we're going to answer the question first of when cloud certs are valuable versus when they might not be. So we're going to teach you to think correctly about the value of a cloud certification. And then we're going to talk about realistically how many of those certs you need in order to get hired. So let's start with some reasons that cloud certs do or do not provide value to your career. And the first reason is that cloud certs give you a broad base of foundational knowledge. Even if you've been an engineer for quite some time working in the cloud, you may have only touched a narrow subset of services, and you may find that there's other engineers working with you who are doing things that you don't understand. Cloud certs attempt to remove that imbalance by giving you a broad base of knowledge across all the major topic areas of the cloud, so you can feel confident that you haven't missed anything. That's valuable professionally, and it's valuable in your job prep. In some sense, if you actually go through the training material and cover what's laid out by that certification path, it almost doesn't matter whether or not you actually take the certification exam. Just covering the material gives you all the real value. Second reason cloud certs can be helpful for your career. Even if hiring managers don't care so much about the cert, recruiters do sometimes filter on that, especially if you're missing a more traditional credential like a computer science degree from a university or college. If you can bring in that certification, that's a signal to the recruiter that, oh, this person's serious. They've got some external validation of the fact that they can sit down and learn and that they know something about the cloud. And again, even though that might not get you the job, it can get your foot in the door for that big interview. Third reason that cloud certs can be helpful for you. I know I said before that hiring managers don't necessarily care about certs, but there is one particular area of the industry where certs are worth way more than paper. In fact, they may be worth their weight in gold, and I'm talking about the consulting industry. Big consulting shops like Accenture or Deloitte, all the way down to smaller consultants and MSPs, they have a bottomless appetite for qualified people with certifications. And there's several reasons for that. First, it's actually the case that a lot of these consulting shops have what are called partnerships with the cloud providers like AWS and Microsoft, and their partnership level increases and they get more benefits out of that as they have more certified people that work for them. So they're always looking to bring in people who have a cert count. In addition to that, of course, if you have a certification, that simply communicates expertise to the consultant's clients. If I'm hiring a consultant, I'd like to know that there's some external validation that they can actually do the job. And then finally, if I've got certified, I may be able to do certain jobs as a consultant that I couldn't do otherwise. When I was in consulting, I used to do a lot of what are called well-architected reviews for AWS. That's where you sit down with a client and you look at their architecture and you determine if it's built correctly according to AWS best practices. It turns out that you can't officially perform a WAR, or well-architected review, on AWS's behalf unless you have an AWS certified solutions architect professional credential. So, lots of reasons why consulting shops absolutely love to hire people with certifications, and you can be that person if you bring those certs in the door. Okay, you get it. Certs aren't magic, but they do provide some value for you. So now the big question, how many of these certs do you need in order to actually go out and get a job in the cloud? Here's what I'm going to recommend that you do. There's no single right answer to this question, but I've seen this work many times over the course of my career and other people that I've worked with and mentored. The first thing I'm going to recommend that you do is go out and get a foundational technical cloud certification. So I'm not talking here about something like the AWS Certified Cloud Practitioner or the Azure 900. Those are great certs, but they're really designed more for non-technical people, and they don't communicate the expertise that you would need to get hired into a cloud job. So I'm talking about something like the AWS Certified Solutions Architect Associates or the Certified Developer Associates, or on the Azure side, something like the AZ 103. Once you've got that foundational technical certification. At this point, I would say set your cert prep aside for the moment and focus on pulling in some of the hands-on expertise that hiring managers are also going to want to see. And the best way to do that is with portfolio projects if you don't have existing experience professionally in the cloud. And there's several key topic areas that you're going to want to know that are going to come up in these interviews. First, you need to be able to code a little bit. So look for something like Python. It's a fantastic back-end programming language that's used by cloud teams the world over. A Cloud Guru has lots of great courses to help you get up to speed on that. You're also going to want to know a little bit about Linux and a little bit about networking. Okay, so on the Linux side, you want to be thinking about, you know, how does the Linux file system work? How do I use the basic commands like your greps and your seds and your aux? Maybe know a little bit about containerization. And then on the networking side, you're going to want to know essentially how the internet is put together. So you want to know the basic protocols like IP and TCP. You'll want to know the layers of the networking stack. You'll want to know a little bit about DNS. What happens when you send a request out of your browser and, you know, it goes to Google and comes back. You'll want to be sufficiently familiar with that. And then you'll want to do some projects that actually put that into practice for you, as well as pulling in some cloud services on top. Once you have done those basic cloud projects and you've got a series of stories that you can tell in an interview, at this point, I would say go ahead and start applying for jobs. While you're doing that, it's okay to go ahead and pursue a more advanced certification like a professional cert or one of the specialty certifications like a security or a networking cert, but you don't have to have that completed, I wouldn't say, in order to actually go out and interview. It's okay for the hiring manager to see that you're still learning and that you don't know everything yet. You're not going to cover everything. And you may say, well, wouldn't it help me even more if I were to go get 3, 4, 5 certifications and have them under my belt before I start applying? And I'm going to say no. Past a certain point, more certs are going to feel like diminishing returns, okay? So on the one end of the spectrum, if you don't have any certifications, it kind of feels like, you know, how do I know that this person knows anything? But if all you're doing is getting certifications and you're not bolstering those with projects, well, at that point, it can feel like, you know, how do I know this person can actually do anything? Maybe they're just doing academic work all the time. So you've got to have a sweet spot. You've got to have a balance in the middle. And that's where a couple of these foundational cloud certs plus the hands-on projects are going to help you. And if you're looking for some projects to do, we do something every month here at A Cloud Guru called the Cloud Guru Challenge. You can find that on social media with the hashtag, and you can sign up for free at acloudguru.com to participate. These are challenges that are specifically designed to give you good stories to tell in a job interview. You'll be doing things like event-driven programming. You'll be working with DevOps technology, CI/CD, Git. You'll be building on serverless and other cloud services, and you'll be able to take those into a job interview, and they're guaranteed to give you something you can talk to your hiring manager about. Okay, and that brings us to the end of this episode of Dear Gurus. Make sure to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel, and don't forget to sign up at acloudguru.com to participate in those challenges and to study a lot of the free courses we have available on code, on Linux, on networking, and on cloud. Finally, comment below, and maybe your question will be featured in the next episode of Dear Gurus.